பயாலஜி இன் தமிழ் கோர்வை சேனல் சார்பாக அனைவருக்கும் வணக்கம். என் பெயர் கண்ணதாசன். இன் திஸ் வீடியோ ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு டீச் யூ அபவுட் வெஸ்டிஜியல் ஆர்கன்ஸ், கனெக்டிங் லிங்க், அட்டாவிஸ்டிக் ஆர்கன். அண்ட் லெட் அஸ் ஸ்டார்ட் திஸ் வீடியோ வித் த பிக்சர். இந்த ப்ரீவியஸ் வீடியோ வி ஃபினிஷ்ட் ஹோமோலோகஸ் ஆர்கன் அண்ட் அனலோகஸ் ஆர்கன். இன் தட் வீடியோ ஐ பிளேஸ்ட் ஆல் த பிக்சர்ஸ் அட் த எண்ட் ஆஃப் த வீடியோ. Now let us start the video with the picture. This is the digestive system of the human being. Before we enter into this video, if you like this video, press the like button, share this video to your friend, comment on it, subscribe our channel to receive more such videos in future, and press the bell icon to receive the notification. And also here I would like to suggest the method of using this video. You have to start with the mindset of a teacher is sitting next to you and teaching this concept. Then you feel very comfortable and take a note and a notebook and pen, and take the note highlighting points in your notebook along with the date, so that at any time in future you want, you can go through it. And also all these notes paper, I am posting it in the Telegram as well as in the WhatsApp. You can download it and you can file it and you can use it. Okay, so this is the method in which you are expected to make utilize of this video. Now let us start the video with this picture. Human being, you see the cecum. The cecum in human being is highly reduced. Then you see the rabbit as a herbivore. It consists of a very long cecum, you see, long cecum. And also a deer, you consist of a, it consists of a very large cecum. So when herbivorous animals are having large cecum, whereas omnivore human being is having a very reduced cecum, so it is called as vestigial organ. Now what is vestigial organ? Let us go to the vestigial organ. That is the first title of our video. And vestigial organs are grouped under evidences for comparative anatomy. Evidences for comparative anatomy under biological evolution. Yesterday itself I told you about biological evolution. Biological evolution is the evolution of an organism from the pre-existing organism by acquiring the new traits which are adapted to the new environmental condition. That is called as biological evolution. To support the biological evolution, we are studying the comparative anatomy of various organisms, in which vestigial organs are, you see, remnants of some organs. Remnants means poorly developed and are not functional. Then it is called as remnants. Remnants of some organs, that is poorly developed and are not functional in present day organism, in human being, but they are well developed in the, well developed as well as functional in our ancestors, then it is called as vestigial organs. Human being consists of many other vestigial organs. Okay, you see the coccyx, the tailbone, wisdom teeth. Wisdom teeth is not fully coming out of gum. So it is called as vestigial. Ear muscles, we are not able to move our ear, that is the pinna, like a dog or cat and cattle. Body hair, we are not having the body hair as the monkey and other mammals are having. And mammae in mammals, in the place of mammary gland, males are having a small circular spot, that is called as mammae. That is also one of the vestigial organ. Nictitating membrane of the eye, it is well developed in birds, it is well developed in other vertebrates, but in human being it is not well developed. Now let us see the pictures here. Okay, now these are the cecum. We already saw the pictures. This is the wisdom teeth. Wisdom teeth is not coming out of the gum, you see. That is the reason why it is called as vestigial organ. This is the ape's eye. Ape's eye consists of the nictitating membrane. Human being is having the nictitating membrane as a dot at the corner of the eye. And this is the ear. These are the ear muscles, which are not well developed in human being. Okay, so it is not able to, that is, move the ear. And this is the coccyx, tail bone. In monkeys and other mammals, the long tails are present. But here the tail bone is very much reduced. That is called as coccyx. Now let us go to the next picture. This is the Archaeopteryx. This is the peripatus. Okay, why I am showing this picture, peripatus? Peripatus are said to be the connecting link between Annelida and Arthropoda. Okay, what is connecting link? It is an organism or group of a species or group of organism which connects the two groups of organism. Here the peripatus connects on one side Annelida, another side Arthropoda. Okay, so because it consists of it is neither included in Annelida nor included in Arthropoda, because it consists of both characters of Annelida and Arthropoda. Characters of Annelida, it consists of segmented body, and segmentally arranged nephridia are also present. And in its outer exoskeleton, outer cuticle, it is not having chitin. Chitin is a very peculiar substance present only in the exoskeleton of Arthropoda. That is absent here. Then you may ask one question: what are the arthropod character it is having, sir? It consists of compound eye, and it consists of segment, that is joint legged structure appendages. Okay, jointed legs. Their legs are jointed legs. That is the reason why the name itself, the phylum name itself, Arthropoda, means joint legged animals. That is the meaning. Okay, but also it is having, like Arthropoda, tracheal respiratory system. So this is one of the connecting link, okay, between the Annelida and Arthropoda. Now this is the Archaeopteryx. This Archaeopteryx consists of characters of reptiles and birds, both reptilian and avian characters. Okay, so reptilian character, what are the reptilian characters, sir? You see, the four limbs consist of claws. Usually birds are not having claws in the four limbs. Okay, and also you see the teeth in their jaws. Okay, and are having the long tail. Okay, so these are the characters of reptiles. As far as the bird's character concerned, it consists of feather, and it consists of beak-like structure, and also its pelvic bone, that is anatomical structure which we cannot see. The pelvic bone give the appearance of bird's pelvic bone. So these are the reason why it is neither placed under reptile nor placed under, though it is fossilized, it is considered as a separate group. Archaeopteryx is considered as a separate group, so it is called as connecting link. So this is also supporting, the connecting link also supporting the biological evolution. So this is an intermediate organism, intermediate or in the transitional stage, Annelida, peripatus, Arthropoda. So it is a transitional organism. Through this organism, from this organism, peripatus only, Arthropoda organisms should have originated. In the same way, birds should have originated from reptiles through the intermediate organisms like Archaeopteryx. Okay, so this is called as connecting link. Next one is atavistic organs. What are atavistic organs? You see, sudden appearance of vestigial organs in highly evolved organism. In highly evolved organism, the particular organ is vestigial, but suddenly it appears in a larger structure, somewhat functional structure also. Then these organs are called as atavistic organ. Appearance of tail in humans. Okay, you see the appearance of tail in humans. This baby, you see the tail, it is having the tail atavism. So this is the atavism character, or this is also called as reversion. So students, today we discussed about vestigial organs. Okay, the organ which is larger in size, having performing a good function. Okay, it is in a functional condition, but in a present day highly evolved organism, it is poorly developed and not functional. Then it is called as vestigial organ. So next one is connecting link. Okay, it stands between the two groups of organism. Then atavistic organ, sudden appearance of vestigial organ. So these are the three concepts we discussed today. Thank you very much for your listening, student. Thank you.